In this video, we are going to discuss on how to reconfigure CO to change the DB user password or update the DB instance TSPS RSSO configuration information. Before we begin, when changing the database schema owner, database account password, it is necessary to reconfigure all the servers that are part of the TrueSite capacity optimization instance, application server, and the ETL engine servers. Introduction to database credential tools. The database credential tool is a common line utility that enables you to validate the database connection, view details of database configured with TrueSite capacity, update the password of the database user on all components of TrueSite capacity optimization. Whenever a database administration changes password for any database user, you can use this utility to update the password of the corresponding users on all TSCO components. Changing other configuration parameters like DB host, TSPS, RSSO, etc. If the TSCO database has been moved to a new server or migrated to a new instance, as first step, you should manually change the tnsnames.ora file or validate the appropriate entry is there. You can even ask your DBAs to do this. Typically, only the DBA will have the access to modify this file. After, you have to run the TSCO installer similar to performing an install or an upgrade. Please refer to official document for your TSCO version. The only official supported method to change the TSCO database instance information, which includes database host name, instance service, DNS names, or anything on TSPS and RSSO, is by running the setup.sh in reconfiguration mode as described below. Once we run the setup.sh file, it asks to reconfigure BMC capacity optimization as we are going to see in our demo. In the command line, execute dbcredential.sh from the sipit-based tools dbcredential folder. The dbcredential tool displays the DB configuration summary and credential status section for the configured users. Click detail configuration to view the details of DB configured with TSCO, or click update to update the password in the components of TSCO for the DB user for which validation has failed and enter the details. We can choose which user we want to do. Once we do the updation, we can save it. Note, only when the validation fails for one or more user credential, the option to update the password is displayed. Otherwise, it will be only detailed configuration and exit. You can use this option to update the password configured in the component of TSCO. Updating password in this utility will not update password in database. Alternatively, we will run the setup.sh in reconfigure mode to change configuration parameter like DB host, TSPS, RSSO, and even here we can change the DB password. Let's see. We are now in installer file, where we'll click next. It asks whether we want to reconfigure or reinstall. So here we are going for reconfigure. It even asks the components we like to install. Port. Now, Here we can give the remedy SSO host and port, TSPS host and port. We can modify it and proceed to next. Once it validates, it asks the repository where we'll select the local. Now it asks for the database type. So here we are selecting as an Oracle. Here we can change the parameters if needed for database, like Oracle client home, configuration folder, SID, host name, port, alias, and then we'll click next. It asks, do you need to update database user password? It has been preferable to use this to change the database user password once it has been changed at the database end. So we'll give yes, I need to update the database user password. Click next. Here we can give the user password which is changed, and then we click next. Here it will ask that it will be ready to reconfigure in the following locations and the features to be released. We'll go with installation options and it will do the modification. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.